Hello dear friends, welcome to the countryside. In this video I shall demonstrate you the operation of a kerosene burning portable stove and a stainless steel Moka Pot coffee making device. As you can see, this portable stove has much in common with a hurricane lantern, being operated by a wick and using kerosene or a modern substitute. The principle of operation is quite simple. You fill the lower container with lamp oil or kerosene, and then the wick draws the fuel in the upper part where it's ignited and you can heat whatever you need to heat. A few minutes after filling up, the fuel is fully absorbed into the wick. It's time to ignite it. For the moment, the flame is quite large and produces a lot of smoke. It's time to adjust the height of the wick and thus lower the intensity of the fuel being delivered. This is very similar to adjusting the flame on a hurricane lantern. Now that we got the fire going, it's time to prepare the coffee. I'll be using this nicely made stainless steel Moka pot that I recently acquired. This is actually a pretty small Moka pot, but it has a very nice design and it's made of stainless steel, which in my opinion is much better than the regular aluminum that usually Moka pots are made of. As with any Moka pot, you put the water in the lower container, and then you put the funnel, and then you put the coffee grounds. Usually when I travel outdoors, I like to use old film canisters to store coffee grounds, sugar, spices or things like that. What I like to do is to tap the coffee grounds very lightly, and as you can see I spilled a bit of coffee and now I'm trying to clean it. It's time to assemble the pot. Once we have the Moka pot on the stove, let's take a closer look at the flame, and also we can take a look through the observation window. On this setup it takes about 8 to 10 minutes to make a cup of coffee. Let's take a quick glance inside to see how the coffee is being produced. The lid is warm to touch. The coffee is starting to appear through the spout of the Moka pot. Once the pot is full with coffee, it's time to remove it. The handle is a bit hot, but I'm trying to cope with it. Sorry about the shaking, as I said before, the handle is not cold. One thing I want to show you is the bottom of the Moka pot. It is black with soot. That's because the burn was incomplete with a very rich flame. We turn off the stove by blowing hard into the flame. Next we add some sugar. I only use one cube. Now it's time to sit down, relax and enjoy the coffee. Until we'll see each other next time, I wish you all the best. Please don't forget to subscribe. Bye bye.